Hi, my name is Ashwini Kumar and welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to see the topic that is how to find out a research topic for the PhD. So the most of the PhD aspirants and the PhD pursuing candidates are also still confusion about this topic, that which type of research topic we have to select and which one is the best one to publish the journals early and all these things. So here I'm going to show you the five steps, that these five steps will really helpful to the PhD aspirants to find out a particular topic, right? So coming into the details, the first thing is research area. Actually, the before finding out the topic, first of all, you have to be cleared with the research area. Generally, the research area is depending upon your post-graduation. That means while coming to the undergraduation, it is a generalized subject. And while coming to the post graduation, we are going to stick to one particular research area. So here I'm going to say you with respect to the examples. With my education, I did the BTech in electronics and communications. That means all the different subjects regarding the electronics and communications will be generalizedly explained in the undergraduation. But while coming to the post graduation in my MTech, I took the VLSI. That is especially a very large scale integrated circuits. That means it is regarding the chip designing. So here the VLSI, that means whatever the specialization is there in your post graduation, that comes under the research area, right? So you must be stick to your research area, then only it will be very easy to find out the research topic, right? So if you stick on to your research area based upon your post-graduation specialization, then coming to the research topic, how we have to find out the research topic based upon the fixed research area that I am going to show you right now in this video. So here I told that the five steps here I am going to show you the how to find out the research topic for your particular research area. So these five steps will really helpful to you. The first one is a Google Scholar. Most of the people will find out the topic in the Google, but you have to find out in the Google Scholar. Okay, not search in the Google, you have to search in the Google Scholar. Second one is the websites. So of course, in the next of this video, I'm going to show you individually about these steps. So how to find out, don't worry. So coming to the websites, you have to find out the particular websites regarding your research area or the research topic. Just like the journal. So whatever the highly reputed or high impact factor journals are there in your particular field or the research area, you have to pick out those journals websites and you have to search in those websites. I will show you right now. And next one is a National Digital Library. So the National Digital Library is already there. It is maintaining by the IIT, that you have to search for the journals here also. And the next one is a Shodh Ganga. So it is a very big website for the Indians, that the huge number of PhD theses is stored in this Shodh Ganga website, that you can able to retrieve the PhD thesis that already did by somebody. It's for the free of cost. And the last one is a guide. So if you once are registered to the PhD in any one of the university or the college, you will be allotted to a guide. That guide will give you some topic based upon their experience or based upon their PhD, right? So we will go into the each and every individual thing in detail. Yeah, so first one is the first step I told you is a Google Scholar. So here you have to search for Google Scholar, right? So click on that one. Then here Google Scholar is there. Click on that one. And it will open like this. Here I already told you that in my example, my research area or else my my post-graduation specialization is VLSI. So just type that keyword VLSI and then click on the search button. Then you can able to see the different journals, right? So you can able to see the different journals, those are published on this VLSI. Out of these different journals, you have to select the journal, particularly which one is the latest one. See here, it's 1993, 1985, 1984 and 1981. So like that, you have to search for the latest journal. Or else, now that it's 2020, so you have to go for the 2019 or the 2018 journals, right? So anyhow, if it is the 2020 journal is there, then it is the best one and it acts like a very good base paper for your PhD topic, right? So after this one, next one is the journals websites. So as per the VLSI, I mean in my stream, IEEE is the best website. So here I am searching for the IEEE Explore. Okay, so it is IEEE Explore. So here I am clicking on this one. So it is the highest impact factor journal in my stream. So after entering into this IEEE Explore, here in the browse, I will go for the journals and magazines. So after clicking on that one, next it will give you one window to search the topic. See here, advanced HSA, and here in the all place, I am searching for the journals or magazines, and here it is asking for the keyword or title. I have only the keyword, because in the starting stage of finding out the topic for the PhD, we will be having only the keywords. We won't have the any topics like that. But of course, while coming to the literature survey, we will be having the titles of the papers and all these things. So right now I am just putting the keyword as a VLSI. And after searching here, see, I got the few papers, few journals, functional verification of DSP based on the board VLSI. And you can check that it is 2016 paper, right? So here you can change the year. That if I want to get the only the 2020 paper, just drag like this. Now it is a 2020. So click on this apply button. Then you are going to get the journals based upon the VLSI, that is my PhD specialization, the papers which are published only in the 2020. That means all these things are the very new topics, right? So if you gone through these 2020 published papers, then you will come to know what exactly the things are going on right now in your research area, right? So out of these things, just check down the titles, and if you want to get the abstracts, then click on that particular topic, then you will be directed to the abstract. Then, so based upon the abstract, if any one of the recent trending topic is interesting or if it is convenient to you after studying this abstract, then you can proceed or you can take the topic as your research topic for your PhD, right? So it is a second step that I want to clear you. And coming to the third step, I told you is a National Digital Library. So here, National Digital Library of Indian Journals. So I'm just clicking on that one. So then it will be directed to National Digital Library of. So it is official website of the National Digital Library. And here you can search. I am putting my keyword, that is VLSI, and click on the search. Then whatever the content, whatever the books or journals are there regarding this VLSI, all these things will pop up on the screen, right? So previously I told that IEEE Explore website. So that IEEE Explore paper is also coming here with the abstract. So you can check down, okay? So the wonderful thing as per this National Digital Library is that if you want to refer any one book or if you want to refer any one research area or the topic, so you can simply put those words here and click on the search. Then you will get the text format or video format or presentation format or audio format or image format you may get. And if you want to change the language, that you may change the language here into the different things are given here. So few different languages are there. So in any one of the language you can select. So if the particular topic whatever you are searching, if that language is there, then it will provide, right? So it is a way of searching in the National Digital Library to find out your topic for the PhD. And next one I told, fourth one is the Shodhganga website. So we are directing into the Shodhganga website. Of course, you can just search for the Shodhganga in the Google. Automatically it will direct into this Shodhganga website. So here you can get the huge number of PhD theses. See, The Shodhganga at the Rate Infibit Center provides a platform for research students to deposit their PhD thesis and make it available to the entire scholarly community in open access. You need not to pay anything. The repository has the ability to capture, index, store, disseminate, and preserve EDDs submitted by researchers. So here also one such blog is there. Same thing, I am putting my keyword, that is VLSI, and just search for that one. So whatever the things we are getting here from the Shodhganga, where we will get the PhD thesis already submitted by the PhD candidates, that you can see here. See, on 5th April 2018, submitted by B. Mahavir, and the guide is Indra Raja Singh. So if you click on this one, see, it is embedding aspects in VLSI design and interconnection networks. So if you click on that one, then it will be directed to the thesis submitted by this B. Mahavir. See, University of Madras, and here the abstract is given, and it is a URL link to get the PhD thesis. So just click on that one, then it will be directed to the different chapters. See the certificates, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. And if you want to open, so you can click on this one, then it will be directed to the whatever the chapter you want. So here I clicked on the certificate, so that's why I got the certificate of the candidate. And if you want to open the chapter 3, just click on that one, then it will be directed to this chapter 3 in his PhD thesis, right? See, so all these things will really helpful to you, the starting point of the PhD and the ending point of the PhD. Well, because the starting point of the PhD is finding out the research topic, and the ending point of the PhD is writing the perfect PhD thesis and submitting this one. So completion of your PhD will be depends upon this PhD thesis only. So like that, it will give you, the Shodhganga website will give you the starting point and ending point of the PhD. Both these two, you will get some clear cut idea, right? And the fifth one, I told you that is a guide, right? So the fifth one is a guide. I can't show you this one in the Google, but because the guide is allotted to you physically. So whatever the, I mean, whoever the guide allotted to you, so based upon that, sometimes the guide may also give you the research topic that you have to find out so and so based upon this one, right? So anyhow, finally, I think these five steps will really helpful for your research work to find out the perfect topic, right? So it is a content that I want to deliver to you from this video through my channel. And in my next video, I'm going to tell you that how to write a research paper in a perfect way, and what are the steps we have to follow, and what are the website which will really guide you to a perfect workout of your research papers, right? So don't forget to subscribe to the channel and tap the bell icon. Thank you and all the best.